Hello students, today we will take a quick revision and will also solve some exercises. Till now in this week we have completed one whole chapter, and what we have studied till now? We have studied simple machine. Simple machine is a basic mechanical device for applying force which makes our work easier and quicker. These are the devices with few or no moving parts, and these devices are used to modify motion and force. We also saw some examples of simple machine as wheel and axle, lever, wedge, pulley, screw, inclined plane. Now students, I want you all to go back to your earlier lectures, go back to those earlier videos where I have explained the working of each and every simple machine and have given their examples or uses. So please go through your lessons once again and revise. After simple machines, we studied magnets. What are magnets? Magnet is a material which produces magnetic field. Magnetic field is invisible, but it gives a property of magnet, which is a force that pulls on other ferromagnetic materials such as iron, and it also attracts or repels other magnets. Then we saw some properties of magnets. What are these properties? That magnets have two poles, north and south pole. Unlike poles attract each other, like poles repel each other, and the poles of magnet cannot be separated from each other. And every magnet has two poles. That means if we cut a magnet into two or more pieces, then each piece will develop two poles, north and south pole. We also studied that our earth also act as a huge magnet, but the geographical north pole of earth is actually magnetic south pole, and the geographical south pole of earth is magnetic north pole. Then we saw some uses of magnets. That magnets are used to construct electric motors, generators, and is also used in speakers. Electric bells also have magnets. Then we saw that maglev trains uses superconducting magnets. Magnets are used to sort magnetic material from scrap. We also saw that the door of refrigerators uses magnet. Then magnetic compass is a good example of magnet. It is helped to find geographical directions. Then magnets are used for other purposes such as cabinet closers, toys, refrigerator magnets, etc. In the end, we studied the type of magnets, that there are two types of magnets, temporary and permanent magnet. Temporary magnets are those magnets which retain their magnetic property only for a short time. They can be made up of iron, cobalt or nickel. These are such magnets which show their magnetic property only if they are under the influence of a strong magnet. If a strong magnet is removed, then their magnetic property also goes away. And then we saw permanent magnets. Those magnets which retain their magnetic property for a long time, and they are strong magnets made up of mixtures from iron, cobalt and nickel. And we saw that permanent magnets may lose their magnetic property if they are beaten or dropped from height or heated at high temperature. We also saw electromagnets. Electromagnets are type of temporary magnets. These are certain material which start acting like a magnet under the influence of electricity. If electricity is passed through this nail, if this iron nail, if a copper wire is wrapped around iron nail and electricity is passed through it, then this nail will start acting as a magnet, and this will be called as electromagnet. If this electricity is removed, then this nail will stop acting as a magnet, or it will lose its magnetism. So this was it what we have studied till now. Now Students, you all have the link of your course book, Science CB, with you over WhatsApp. You have received the CB over WhatsApp. So I want you to go through the exercises. Section A is on page number 7. It is picture based question. There are some pictures are given and you have to answer that which type of simple machines are shown below, identifying the picture. Question number 2 is also identify the types of magnets. So section A is picture based question on page number 7. You can solve it. Then on section B is on again on page number 7. It has answer the following questions. You can answer the questions in whatever notebook available to you. And section C is an activity based or query based questions. 2 questions are there. You can try them. And if you find any doubt or any query, then you may ask me on my mail. So students, I request you to go through your all lessons and solve the exercises. Thank you.